Hello friends, welcome to Aasaan IAS. Hope you are enjoying the program Transform into an IAS Officer in 100 Days. Friends, if you can believe, you may start. But if you can understand, you will achieve. You know, I have divided ancient Indian history into four parts. First, we talk about Stone Age, Indus Valley Civilization, Vedic Age, Mahajanapadas, Jainism, Buddhism, etc. Then we talk about Mauryan Empire, pre and post Mauryan invasions. Then we talk about the Satavahanas and down south. And finally, we talk about the Gupta Empire, Harsha Empire and miscellaneous kingdoms. The first part, here we have Stone Age, Indus Valley Civilization, Vedic Age or Vedic period, Mahajanapadas and religious movements like Jainism and Buddhism. In this video, I am going to talk about Mahajanapadas. Not very important topic. Very simple topic and very occasionally, maybe once in 5-6 years, a question can be asked in prelims. What we discuss here? First, we will talk about the later Vedic period. I will continue here also. Janapadas. Then we talk about Mahajanapadas and Magadha is very important out of them. So, the rise of Magadha we discuss in detail. Let me start with the Janapadas. See, it is nothing but later Vedic period. So, I am starting from later Vedic period. We have already seen there some Rajas. Rajas means chieftains. Rajan. So they performed big sacrifices. Example, Ashwamedha. They used to let the horse run and the entire area will be claimed by them. So the Rajas who performed big sacrifices were recognized as being Rajas of Janapadas rather than Janas. Jana means people. Janapada means it is the area, I mean it is the land where these people have set their foot. Jana, Pada. Pada means legs, foot. So that means now the importance was given to Janapada, the area, not the people, not the group of people. That means tribe is not important. The leader is not just for one tribe. It is the Raja. I mean, he is going to be the Raja of the entire land. So Janapadas. You know, this is an important point. This period is known as painted greyware. Period of painted greyware. So this was a period of painted greyware. Plates and bowls are the most common vessels made out of painted greyware. So you see, if you remember, painted pottery started in Chalcolithic culture, Copper Age mein. Then Bronze Age mein, it continued. That time, you know, the color, I told you in Indus Valley Civilization, that was ochre color pottery, OCP. The deposits of ochre color pottery were found, belong to that period. Then, in early Vedic period, it was black and red ware culture. Black and red ware was popular in early Vedic period or Rig Vedic period. That means before invention of iron. Then in the Iron Age, this is all Iron Age. Now, during the period of Janapadas, iron was there. Now, this is painted grey ware. A chronology mind mein rakhiye. Ochre color pottery, black and red ware culture. Then 1200 to 600 BC ki baat kar raha hoon. This is painted grey ware. After this, after painted greyware, during the time of Mahajanapadas, when you know the urban culture started again, this is the second urbanization. First urbanization was during the time of Indus Valley Civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, and second urbanization is in Gangetic Valley. So in this period, I mean then northern black polished ware. So hope you are getting ochre color pottery, black and red ware, then painted greyware and northern black polished ware. So, Northern Black Polished Ware, NBPW, or simply Northern Black Pottery, is an urban Iron Age culture of the Indian subcontinent lasting 700 to 200 BC. Exactly years yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi, but chronology mind mein rakhe. Hope you are getting. This is the time of Mahajanapadas. I will talk about Mahajanapadas in a while. So, Vedic period, early Vedic period, there was no iron, and that was Rig Vedic period, that is black and red ware culture. Then, you know, slowly Janapadas has started growing in the later Vedic period, that is during the Iron Age. And out of those Janapadas, certain Janapadas become more popular and that is known as Mahajanapadas. Now we talk about Mahajanapadas. So the vast majority of people lived in villages. The institution of Jati. See, later Vedic period, Varna system came. That means only four Varnas. Now, Jati or caste. Jatis are more than four. Many. many jatis. So that institution of jati had come into existence during this time. There was strengthening of patriarchal control within the household. We have seen in early Vedic period, you know, woman was given importance. Now slowly patriarchal control is getting strengthened. The two competing types of politics were oligarchies and monarchies. Monarchy means one ruler, one head. Oligarchy means group of people, gana or sanghas. So this is all slowly it has started. It is changing. This is not a change overnight. I am talking over a period of hundreds of years. Slowly it is changing. Now we talk about Mahajanapadas. So there were many Janapadas. First there were leaders of the tribes, Jana. Jana was important. Slowly they did some yagnas or sacrifices like Ashwamedha and they started claiming the land. Then they formed Janapadas. Then out of them certain Janapadas become more popular and they occupied the neighborhood Janas and they became more prominent. They are known as Mahajanapadas. So around 600 BC, some Janapadas became more important than others and were known as Mahajanapadas. Most Mahajanapadas had a capital city. Many of these were fortified, probably because people were afraid of attacks from other kings and needed protection. See, before they were not attacking like that. There was no standing army also before. Now slowly the things are changing. So now there is a capital city, even many of them are fortified. The main reason for this development is why there is a shift from Janapadas to Mahajanapadas. What benefits they got? One is weapons. Weapons because of the increasing use of iron. So iron was discovered and you know they started using iron. Jiska iron resources, especially Magadha kind of regions. So they started making weapons out of it. So similarly agricultural tools that they can made with iron. So if there is like instead of having wooden plowshare, if they have iron plowshare, they can produce more food. Then they can maintain standing army also. So all these things have helped them. Similarly, taxes. Before the taxes, you know, it was not compulsory. Like it was like a gift they used to give to the Rajan. There was no standing army. But as the rulers of Mahajanapadas were building huge forts and maintaining big armies, they needed more resources and they needed officials to collect these. So instead of depending on occasional gifts brought by people, as in the case of the Raja of Janapadas, Janapadas and later Vedic period, we have seen that it was occasional gift. There is no compulsion that tax must be paid. But here, they started collecting regular taxes. Especially taxes on crops were the most important. Because that time, this was the major thing. So agricultural tax. This was because most people were farmers. Usually the tax was fixed at 1/6 on what was produced. This is known as bhaga or share. That means this share should be given to the Raja so that they can use this for maintaining that army and other things and other officials and all. So this way slowly the transformation is coming and state formation began. Now we talk about important, out of these Mahajanapadas, 16 Mahajanapadas are there. First thing, exam point of view mein. Abhi tak jo bhi bola, broadly samajh lijiye, ab exam point of view mein baat karenge. Pehle aapko batana chahiye, unki location kahan pe hai. Kabhi kabhi map mein, which A, B, C, D, 4 points dikhayega aur puchega, usko identify karo. So rough idea hona chahiye, western most kya hai, eastern side kya hai, southern side kya hai. Ye 16 Mahajanapadas ka position aapko mind mein hona chahiye. First, if you see, I am coming from the westmost, northwest, Cambodia. Then we have here Gandhara. I will explain about all of them one by one. First, you see the position. Cambodia means present-day Pakistan-Afghanistan border. Gandhara, present-day Pakistan, Takshila and all. Then we have Kuru. Kuru was the most important Mahajanapada. One of the, the largest Mahajanapada in the beginning. I will talk about them. Kuru, that means present-day Delhi. Then we have uska niche Matsya. I will give the capitals also and important points also. Then you better understand. Filhal ke liye just identify the location. Kuru, Matsya is northern Rajasthan. Then we have Panchala. देन उसके नीचे सूरसेना, कुरु नीचे मत्स्य, देन ईस्टर्न साइड आएंगे तो पांचाला सूरसेना, देन वी हैव अवंती हियर, देन सबसे नीचे अश्मका, आई मीन तेलुगु पीपल, प्रेजेंट डे तेलंगाना एंड महाराष्ट्र, अश्मका. Again, if you come towards eastern side, we have Koshala, then we have Vatsa, then we have Chedi. Again, further east, we have Malla, here we have Kashi. Further east, we have Vaji, we have Magadha, and easternmost, Anga. You spend some time and please identify these positions. Not exactly, एक approximate idea. At least Avanti, Ashmaka, Anga, Kamboja दिया होगा तो you should not get confused. इतना broad questions ही आता है, but you need to know. Kamboja को आप Ashmaka का जगह पे नहीं लिखना चाहिए. Hope you are getting. Now we talk about them one by one. First I talk about Kamboja. There is nothing to talk, it is not important. Just इसका capital था Rajpura. It was a republic. Republic means the leader will be elected. Kautilya's Arthashastra and Ashoka ka edict number 13 was there. So they attest that Kamboja has followed Republican constitution. But anyway, it has nothing to take it seriously. Just location mind mein rakke, rest all you can forget if you want. Then we have Gandhara. The capital of Gandhara is Takshila. It is important because Takshila University is also there. It is a monarchy. Panini and Kautilya, you know, Panini who wrote Ashtadhyayi and Kautilya who wrote Arthashastra and the minister of Chandragupta Maurya, they are the products of Takshila University. Takshila University pe mains pe questions aate rehte hai kabhi kabhi. So Panini and Kautilya are the students of Takshila University. Gandhara was located on the Grand Northern High Road, which is called Uttarpada, and it was a center of commercial activities. So itna information aap jaaniye Gandhara ke bare mein. At least. Hope you are getting. After that, we talk about Kuru and Panchala. These are very important. I will tell you about them. So, Kuru, the capital was Hastinapur and Indraprastha. Indraprastha near Delhi, Hastinapur near Meerut. Earlier it was monarchy, later shifted to republic. But SRA yaad rakhne ki jarurat nahi. Similarly, you have Panchala here. The capital was Ahichatra or Kampila, you can call it. Present day, which is a part of Uttar Pradesh. It is monarchy. Now we will see in detail about Kuru and Panchala. You remember I told you about Bharata tribe? In Rigveda it was mentioned about battle of 10 kings, Dasha Rajana, where Sudas of Bharata tribe fought against confederation of 10 tribes and won the battle. I am talking about that Bharata tribe, which is very important. One more popular tribe is Puru. So the two major tribes, Bharatas and Purus, combined and formed the Kuru people. You know Kuru people, Kauravas and Pandavas, they are Kuru people. You know Kuru, it was the largest state after the Indus Valley civilization. Actually state formation yahan se shuru hua hai. Main kab ki baat kar raha hu, main 9th century BC ki baat kar raha hu. जो अदर स्टेट्स है जो मगधा एंड ऑल वे सारे 6th सेंचुरी BC टाइम पे पॉपुलर हुआ है. सबसे पहले द फर्स्ट लार्ज स्टेट इन दिस साउथ एशिया इज कुरु विच वाज फॉर्मड बाय भरतास एंड पुरुष टुगेदर. गेटिंग मी? ग्रेजुअली दे कोएलेस्ड विद द पांचालास हु ऑक्युपाइड द सेंट्रल पार्ट ऑफ द दुआब. पांचालास आर यू नो फ्रॉम द एरिया प्रेजेंट डे दिल्ली. And Kurus are from the present day Haryana and that Punjab area. You know Kurukshetra war between Kauravas and Pandavas. Kurukshetra is in Haryana. So the authority of Kuru Panchala people spread over Delhi and the upper and central parts of the Doab. So they set up their capital at Hastinapur and of course Indraprastha. So with the Kuru Panchala kingdom was very popular during that time. I am talking about the period of painted graveware. That's why the painted graveware deposits you find in this area. Getting me? And other Mahajanapadas, you know, that is northern black polished ware. Baad mein hai, iski baad. Getting me? So the first large kingdom is like large state was this Kuru state, Kuru Panchala combination. Then we talk about Matsya. Below Kuru, here is Kuru, and below that you have Matsya. Not very important. Capital, Viratnagar. You know, also known as Bairat. Now, Bairat is in Rajasthan, near Jaipur. Bairat. You will get about this in temple architecture also. The earliest evidence of structural temples are found at Bairat. So, here is a tribal polity. But no need to remember. And here is Surasena. Surasena is important. I will talk about this. The capital of Surasena was Madura. You know Madura? Even a place for Krishna. Tribal polity again. Now I will talk about Surasena. Surasena. There were various tribes that inhabited the region and they were headed by a chief. So tribal polity. The chief of the Surasena was Avantiputra. Of course, there could be many. One of the known, Avantiputra, who was the first among the chief disciples of Buddha. So he was contemporary of Gautam Buddha, Avantiputra. Even Pradyota. Pradyota ke baare mein hum Avanti mein baat karenge. One of the popular king of Avanti. He had a close relation with this Avantiputra. Even, you know, Surasena ke baare mein it was mentioned in Ramayana. And even ancient Greek writers like Megasthenes and all. So they refer the people of this Surasena kingdom as Yadavas. Yadava king's kingdom. So Surasena is important. Mathura is the capital. That's why it is popular for Vrindavan and all. You know, popular religiously for Lord Krishna. Surasena, Janapada was conquered by Mahapadmananda around 350 BC. So later, it was added to Magadha. So at the time of Nandas, so it was taken up by Magadha and it was added to that. But anyway, not to take it very seriously. So Mathura Yadrake, and you remember Avantiputra, who was contemporary of Gautam Buddha and one of the first chief disciples of Buddha. After that, we talk about Avanti. Very important kingdom, very powerful of that time. Capital was Mahishmati. Jai Mahishmati. Bahubali mein Rajmali sahab yahan se uthaya hai. Mahishmati or Mahishati. And Ujjain. So it was monarchy. I will talk about Avanti now. This point is not very important. Just for an idea I am telling you. The earliest rulers of Avanti according to Puranas were the Haihayas. Yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi. So, Haihayas actually, you know, they are confederation of five clans. So, they were the earliest rulers of Avanti. Like, Vithihotras, Bojas, they sab milke banaya hai, Haihayas. The last ruler of the was overthrown by his minister, Kulika. Again, no need to remember. Who placed his son, Pradyota, very very important name, you have to remember Pradyota, on the throne. So, unka last ruler ka minister Pulika ne unka vohotro karke unka beta ko baitaya hai simhasan pe. Unka naam hai Pradyota. So, this all you need not remember, but you need to know about Pradyota. Pradyota was contemporary to Gautam Buddha. Again, question puch sakta hai, who of the following is a contemporary of Gautam Buddha? Or, he is not a contemporary of Gautam Buddha? Aisa question aata rehta hai. So, Pradyota was contemporary of Gautam Buddha. He was also known as Chanda Pradyota Mahasena. Hope you are getting. Actually what happened, he invited Buddha to Avanti. You see, Buddha has not visited Avanti or Gandhara, Kamboja. We sare Gangetic plains mein hi different kingdoms jaake he was giving his preachings. So Pradyota invited Buddha to Avanti. But Buddha declined at that time. By that time, you know, he invited, he already got old. So Buddha declined to go because of his old age and deputed Mahakatyayana. Mahakatyayana was one of the disciples of Gautam Buddha who belonged to Ujjain, that is Avanti kingdom. So he sent him to give the teachings. And even Pradyota's queen, that means wife of Pradyota, her name no need to remember, Gopal Mata, mother of Gopal, the further king of Avanti after Pradyota. So Gopal Mata became the disciple of this Mahakatyayana, and even they got constructed a stupa to Mahakatyayana, Ujjain mein. But yeh saare aapko jarurat rahe. Sirf itna samajh lijiye, Pradyota was an important king of Avanti, ek point mind mein rakhe. Second point, he was contemporary to Gautam Buddha. Third point, he invited Gautam Buddha to Avanti, but Buddha never visited Avanti because of his old age, and he appointed Mahakatyayana to give the preachings there. Hope you got it. Hi, hi, as vagara yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi. I am continuing. These are also important points. Magadha's most serious rival was Avanti, because Magadha was also growing at that time and Avanti was very powerful. So Avanti fought with Bimbisara. Bimbisara ke bare mein hum Magadha mein padhenge, Rise of Magadha mein. So Bimbisara, but became friends. Because, you know, Bimbisara had this, what you call, vision. Agar ve kisi ko defeat nahi kar sakta hai, to ve uske saath relation banate hai. So fought with Bimbisara, but became friends. When Chandaprajyot Mahasena was ailing with jaundice, Bimbisara kya kya? Unko mauka mila hai. Chalo, ab usko dost banayenge. So he sent his royal physician Jivak. This is also an important name to Ujjain. So when Prajyot ko jaundice tha, to Bimbisara ne apna royal physician Jivak ko beja hai to help him. I mean, to treat him. So ye bhi, Bimbisara sent whom? Who of the following to Ujjain when Chandaprajyot Mahasena was ailing with jaundice? Aisa question choti exam mein puch sakta hai. The answer is Jivak. He was a great physician of Bimbisara court. Similarly, even, you know, this Prajyot was very powerful. He waged a war on, no need to remember the name, vaisa bata raha hun, Pushkar Sarin, who was king of Gandhara. Then, you know, that king Gandhara sent a letter and embassy to Bimbisara seeking his help, because they were friends and all. So that's why, no need to remember, but understand the importance of Avanti and Magadha. Pratyodha captured the Vatsa king Udayana. I will talk about him also in a while. So Vatsa, you can see here, this is Vatsa, whose capital is Kaushambya. I will talk about Vatsa in a while. So Avanti, he also captured Vatsa king Udayana, but later he married his daughter. Pratyodha ne apna daughter ko, whose name is Vasavadatta, to Udayana. Udayana ke saath marry karwaya. Not very important, but hope you are getting. This is important. This Jivakwala. This point is important. King Nandivardhana of Avanti was defeated by King Shishunaga. So you see, Bimbisara Avanti ko kuch defeat nahi kar paya. Baad mein, even we talk about Ajatasatru. Ajatasatru was the son of Bimbisara. Then he became the ruler of Magadha. Then, you know, at that time, Avanti was so powerful, Ajatasatru darke apna capital Rajgriha, Rajgir. So usko fortification kiya tha. So he fortified Rajgriha to protect it from the invasion by Prajyodha. So itna darta. Baad mein Shishunaga dynasty aaya hai Magadha mein. Then Shishunaga king ne isko Avanti ko haraya hai. Ye sare hum Magadha mein discuss karenge. Hope you got about Avanti. After Avanti, we talk about Asmaka. Not very important. Just you see, it is the southernmost. Capital was Potna or Potali, a monarchy. Even Panini mentioned about Asmakas, but no need to understand all this. Just position, location mind mein rakhe. Then we talk about Kosala, very important. Capital was Shravasti, one of the largest city of Buddha time. Even, you know, it is told that 9 lakh people used to live in this city at that time. See, we see time, 6th century BC, pe hi, 9 lakh people, I mean, maybe exaggeration, but one of the greatest city of that time, Shravasti, capital of Kosala. Similarly, Vatsa, Vatsa ki baat karenge hum. Capital was Kaushambi, again, one of the greatest city. It was monarchy. Similarly, we have Chedi, Chedi kingdom. Chedi is not very important. Kosala and Vatsa are important. I will talk about them. Chedi, Suktimati was the capital. It was monarchy. Even, you know, it is also one of the most ancient tribes. Like Rigveda, maybe I mentioned kya tha. Like Shishupala, you know, enemy of Krishna, you know, Shishupala, 100 mistakes and all. So who was a Chedi ruler? But koi caste ka nahi aapko exam point of view mein. Kosala and Vatsa are important. I will talk about them. First, we talk about Kosala. Very important. Kosala is closely associated with the life of Buddha. Because Buddha had spent 24 years of his life in this kingdom. After attaining enlightenment, in his last day, Buddha was in Kosala only. In fact, the king of Kosala, Prasenjit, remember, very important. You can also call it Pasenadi. He was disciple of Gautam Buddha, means contemporary of Gautam Buddha, one of the chief disciples of Buddha. And Gautam Buddha spent 24 years of his life in Kosala. And the capital of Kosala at that time was Shravasti, very important city, one of the largest city of those days, Shravasti. It was the capital of Kosala. And it was one of the largest cities of Buddha time. It is also birthplace of Jaina Tirthankar Sambhavnath. You know, that's why it is an important place for Jains also. You know, Sambhavnath, third Tirthankara of Jainas. We'll talk about Tirthankaras of Jains in Jainism Buddhism topic. Sambhavnath, the symbol of Sambhavnath was horse. Sambhavnath, you know, according to Jain texts, his height is 1200 meters. Exam mein nahi puchega, waisa bata raha hu. I don't know how he used to enter into a house. 1200 meter is the height of Sambhavnath. Anyway, that is all not required. Shravasti mind mein rakhe, Prasenjit mind mein rakhe, Buddha has spent lot of his time in this Kosala kingdom. Ye mind mein rakhe. Again an important point. Princess of Kosala, who is sister of Prasenjit, was the first wife of Magadha king Bimbisara. We learn about this in Magadha. Bimbisara, who got 3 marriages, because you know, with marriage alliances also he extended his empire, his kingdom. So first wife was sister of Prasenjit. Hope you understand these points. Then we talk about Vatsa. See, this is Vatsa. This is Kuru. Then later they joined with, coalesced with Panchala. So Kuru Panchala kingdom was very popular in the ancient time. I mean, out of all Mahajanapadas, oldest you can say. Then the Vatsas were a branch of the Kuru in the early Vedic period. Like, they are part of Kurus only. Maybe, you know, some of them are a kind of unika log hai idhar. In later Vedic period, they split from Kurus. Hope you are getting, but no need to take it very seriously. Udayana was an important king of Vatsa, who was the ruler of Vatsa in 6th century BC, and he was contemporary of Gautam Buddha. You know, who has good friendship with even this Pratyoga. His mother, Mrigavati, not very important, just for an idea I am saying, is notable for being one of the earliest known female rulers in Indian history. So Mrigavati, mother of Udayana, female ruler of that time only. So Vatsa is known for this. Hope you are getting. After that, we talk about Malla. You know, the capital was Kushinagar and Pava. Both are very important places. Republic, no need to remember. See, Kushinagar, Buddha died at Kushinagar. Mahaparinirvana of Buddha happened at Kushinagar. Very important. Similarly, Vardhaman Mahavir died at Pava. You can also call Pavapuri. We'll talk about them in Jainism Buddhism also. That's why Malla, you remember, Kushinagar and Pava. Then we have here Kashi. Kashi was a very powerful kingdom initially. Like 9th century and all, that time Kuru was powerful, this side Avanti was powerful, and 7th century at that time Kashi was very powerful in the eastern Gangetic plain. Baad mein Magadha became powerful. So Kashi, the capital was Varanasi, again very important city of those days, of course now also. So it was monarchy, initially most powerful, not very important, just for an idea I am saying. King Brihadratha of Kashi conquered Kosala, but later incorporated into Kosala by King Kansa. Ye yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi. But you remember Kashi, one of the powerful kingdom initially, capital was Varanasi. Finally, we have here Vaji, very important, I will talk separately. So jiska capital hai Vaishali, very important city again. Then we have Magadha, earlier capital was Rajgir, later it was shifted to Pataliputra. So Rajgir was also, Rajgriha was also an important city. Then we have the easternmost, that is Anga. Champa was the capital. So it was monarchy annexed by Magadha first. Magadha annexed Anga at the time of Bimbisara only. I will tell you about this in Magadha. So Bimbisara annexed Anga and put it under his son Ajatasatru. So it was mentioned in other Veda as despised people. That means they do not follow Varna system and all. So that it was mentioned in other Veda like that. Hope you got it. See, very easy to remember. If you look at it, like, I'll just give you the location. Kamboja, not very important. Gandhara is important because of Takshila. देन आउटसाइड द प्लेन्स, गंगा यमुना दुआब की आउटसाइड की बात करें, हियर वी हैव अवंती, राइट, उज्जैन एंड महिष्मति वाज कैपिटल, इट वाज पॉपुलर बिकॉज ऑफ प्रद्योता, सो ऑल द पॉइंट्स रिलेटेड टू हिम यू रिमेंबर बिकॉज ही वाज कंटेम्पररी ऑफ गौतम बुद्ध. सी जो कंटेम्पररीज है वे सारे बुद्धिस्ट टेक्स्ट में क्लियरली मेंशनड है, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव क्लियर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट देम, हेंस देयर इज अ हाई चांस ऑफ आस्किंग अ क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जाम. होप यू आर गेटिंग. Similarly, Ashmaka is there, not very important. Panini also has mentioned about them. Then here, if you come here, here is, of course, here Matsya hai, jo Rajasthan mein, Bairat or Viratnagar capital mein. Then we have Kuru, Delhi capital, Indraprastha. Then Kuru ke niche Matsya ho gaya idhar, southwest mein. Then Kuru, here is, we have Panchala, and Panchala ka toda niche Sursena, jo with, what you call, मदुरा एज कैपिटल, जो यमुना रिवर ऐसा आती है, I mean, not accurate, ऐसा जाती है, so मदुरा is on the bank of यमुना, similarly we have the capital, it is also Indraprastha on the bank of यमुना, and this is Gangetic, hope you are getting, Ganga river. Now these two are outside, this is outside, this is outside, this is outside, remaining all in the Ganga Yamuna duop. Okay, so this is Kuru, this is Matsya, this is Panchala, this is Sursena, here is you have what you call Vatsa, right? So Kuru, Panchala, Vatsa, here you have Kosla, then you have Chedi, again outside this doab, Yamuna aisa chale jate hai, so here is Chedi. Then after this we have Malla and Kashi, right? Then we have Vaji, Magadha, Anga. So hope you understand this. First we talk about Vaji, very important. See, Vaji is a confederacy of 8 clans. Out of them, Lichavi, very very important. Lichavi, Gnatrika, at least you remember these two. Otherwise, Lichavi, Gnatrika, Vaideha, these clans are very prominent out of these 8. So at least remember Lichavi and Gnatrika. I'll tell you why. So that's why this form of government is known as Gana or Sangha. That means not one ruler, there will be many rulers. All the chiefs of these clans, they meet in assemblies, they discuss and decide what to do, what decision to take. Oligarchy. Hope you are understanding Vaji. Now you see, Challana, the daughter of Lichavi chief Chetana. She was the second wife of Bimbisara. You know the first wife, the sister of Prasenjit. Bimbisara got 3 marriages because he extended his empire with these matrimonial alliances. So Challana, daughter of Lichavi chief, was the second wife of Bimbisara. Trishala, sister of Lichavi chief Chetana. Chetana ka sister Trishala is the mother of Vardhaman Mahavir, the 24th Tirthankara of Jains. So Vardhaman Mahavir, unki mother hai Trishala, who was sister of Lichavi chief Chetana. See, ye sare blood relations wagera, uspe koi question nahi banega. Just names mind mein rakhe. Getting me? Now, that's why, you know, this Lichavi is very important. Similarly, even if you see the father of Vardhaman Mahavira, he is Siddhartha. He belongs to Gnatrika clan. So that's why that is also an important one. So hope you understand this. You know, in various Buddhist texts, it is written very positively about Gana or Sangha. This kind of polity was praised. Like some of the most vivid descriptions of life in the Sanghas can be found in Buddhist books. Even, you know, no need to remember, just for an idea I am telling you, Ajatasatru, the son of Bimbisara. Bimbisara maintained good relation with the with matrimonial alliances. But his son Ajatasatru, who was very aggressive in expanding his empire, he wanted to attack Vajis. Then he sent his minister, his name was Vasakara, don't remember. He sent him to Buddha to get his advice on this matter. Then Buddha ne usse pucha tha, agar Vajis frequently meet kar raha hai in assemblies, then you know they are following proper established rules, and you know if they do this and they are respecting and supporting the elders, they are listening to the elders, and Vaji women are not being held by force, Similarly, Chaityas were maintained well in both towns and villages of Waji Empire if they are following all these things, since they are doing it, because in Ganas and Sanghas they are very prosperous according to Buddha. So that's why until they follow all the things, they cannot be, you know, attacked. That means they prosper. Vajis prosper. That is what Buddha replied. So that is what I mean to say. Exam point of view may koi point nahi hai, but they were praised. These Ganas and Sanghas have good reputation. Even you see, you know, the capital of Vajis, Vaishali, it is a very important city. At least you remember these major cities like Shravasti, Kosala Kingdom ka. Similarly, Ayodhya, the old name was Saketa. Similarly, we have Kaushambi, Vaishali, Rajgriha, which I will discuss, Varanasi. These are all very important cities of those days. So at the time of Buddha, Vaishali was in Vaji Janapada. We know that. After leaving Kapilavastu for renunciation, he came to Vaishali first. You know, Kapilavastu chodke pehle, he wanted to learn about life. So Buddha, we learn about this in Buddhism topic. Buddha first went to two teachers. First he went to Alara Kalama, then he went to Uddaka Ramputta. He learned whatever they can teach to him, but still he could not find answers to his questions. Then he went to Bodh Gaya and all that. He got enlightened. That is all we learn in detail in Buddhism. So, he kahan te Alara Kalama and Uddaka Ramputta ve kahan milata? Vaishali mein hi milata. That's why Vaishali is important. Hope you are getting. So, Vajis. Now, Magadha is also important, but it is too big. So, I will make it as a separate concept. So, we will talk in detail about Magadha, the rise of Magadha. You know, Magadha became the most important Mahajanapada in about 200 years. So, initially Kashi was powerful in this area, Eastern Gangetic Plains. But slowly in 200 years, Magadha became very important. Because one of the reasons for the growth is many rivers. Like Ganga is here. You can see Ganga is flowing like this. See, Magadha capital, pehle Rajgriha, then baad mein Pataliputra. So, Ganga is here. Then Gagra is joining here, little Age Gandak is joining, and niche se Son is joining. So many rivers. So rivers are important because of, you know, communication. So it is easy for communication. Getting me? So this was important for transport, water supplies, and making the land fertile. So more fertile land, more agricultural produce, so they can maintain standing army. So one major cause for their growth was the river system. Second is, parts of Magadha were forested. Because of these forests, elephants which lived in the forest now could be captured and trained for the army. So forests also provided wood for building houses. That's why, you know, Pataliputra was a city of wooden towers and houses. So they can be used for building houses, carts and chariots. So besides, there were iron ore mines in that region. So, more agricultural tools, so better agricultural produce. Similarly, they can make weapons out of those iron tools. Getting me? So, because of these natural resources, one resource was transport because of the rivers. Second resource, because of the rivers, fertile land. Third resource, because of the forest, they got elephants. Fourth resource, because of the iron ore, they got weapons as well as agricultural tools. So all these things helped them to grow. It was mentioned in other Veda for not following Varna system. Like Magadha and Anga, they did not follow Varna system. They are considered as despised people by other Veda. Then Brihadratha dynasty, the earliest ruling dynasty of Magadha. Brihadratha, also known as Maharatha, was the founder of Brihadratha dynasty. Getting me? So Brihadratha dynasty was the earliest dynasty. The name of Brihadratha is also found in the Rigveda. That means very old. That time it was not popular, but it was the earliest dynasty, maybe very small people. I mean, a kind of small tribal leader, but not very important. This is very important point. After Brihadratha dynasty, it came Haryanka dynasty. Haryanka dynasty. During this time, Magadha became prominent. So Magadha came into prominence under the leadership of Bimbisara. So you remember, so Bimbisara. Bimbisara is the king, belongs to Haryanka dynasty. What he has done, I mean, he is a contemporary of Gautam Buddha, even very close friend of the father of Gautam Buddha. You know, Rajgir was the early capital of Magadha at that time. So Bimbisara, when he was ruling, Rajgriha was the capital. So after the great departure, because Gautam Buddha could not learn from those two teachers, Alarakalama and Buddhakaramputta, whatever they know, they have taught him, but still his questions were unanswered. So what he has done, he has left the house, palace, and he went to do whatever he wanted to learn himself. So that is what we call Mahanishkramana. After that, he first went to Rajgriha, Gautam Buddha. That's why he is attached to Magadha also, Gautam Buddha. He started begging alms over there in that Rajgriha, and he was living life of an ascetic. So then even King Bimbisara, what he has done, he visited Gautam Buddha and he asked him, I mean, he even offered half of his throne, half of his empire to Gautam Buddha. Maybe if there is any, maybe ghar pe jhagda karke aaya hoga soch ke, he offered his throne. Agar aap chahte hai toh mera kingdom le lo. Getting me? But Gautam Buddha refused. He turned it down and he wanted to know, I mean, answers to his questions. So Bimbisara is a contemporary of Gautam Buddha. So he captured Anga. The first one to capture was Anga. Anga was here, the easternmost part. So he captured Anga and he kept it under his son Ajatasatru. Again, important point. He extended his empire. One of the reason for this was he with marriage alliances. So marriage alliances strengthened his position. मैं बिंबिसारा की बात कर रहा हूँ. He had three wives. First wife, princess of Kosala, sister of Prasenjit, I already told you. Second wife, Chalana, the daughter of Lichavi chief, Chetana. And third wife was daughter of chief of Madra clan. Madra clan, you know, they belong to Punjab area. Okay. So, marriage alliance strengthened the position of Bimbisara. Even, you know, Magadha's most serious rival was Avanti. Avanti was also very powerful, so it fought with Bimbisara, but they became friends, because when Prajyot was ailing with jaundice, Bimbisara sent his royal physician Jivak, I told you already, so to Ujjain. That's why they became friends. Even, you know, King of Gandhara, whom Prajyot fought, so then, you know, this he sent a letter and embassy to Bimbisara to help. So that means they accepted Bimbisara is powerful, he is the person who can help. That means he is growing. That is what you can understand out of this. So in the beginning, the capital was Rajagriha, present day Rajgir. Rajagriha, that time it was also known as Girivraja. After Bimbisara, he was succeeded by Ajatasatru. So Bimbisara was succeeded and killed by his son Ajatasatru. Ajatasatru was very cruel, aggressive, no respect for elders. So he pursued aggressive policy of expansion. He fought two wars. One was against alliance of Kosala and Kashi. You know, Kosala and Kashi were very friendly with Bimbisara. Even Bimbisara first wife is the sister of Prasenjit, who was Kosala king. But you know, because of his aggressive policy, they became against Ajatasatru. They were also very strong. So Ajatasatru fought with them almost for 16 years. And he won this by manipulating the minister of Prasenjit, Durgachand. Ek reason ye tha jeetne ka. Dusra war he fought with Vajis, led by Lichavis of Vaishali. You know Lichavi princess, the daughter of Chetana, Chalana. Chalana is the second wife of Bimbisara, and you know Ajatasatru is her son. That means unki mother ki kingdom pe hi vene fight kiya hai. No respect for elders, you can say. Why? Because they are supporting Kosala and Kashi. Getting me? And you know the reason for him to win these battles. One, you know he manipulated the Prasenjit's minister. Second is he had two innovative things at that time. One was कैटापल्ट जो बड़ी बड़ी पत्थर को फेंक देता है, आपने बाहुबली मूवी में देखा होगा। सेकेंड इज यू नो ए मेस अटैच टू चैरियट, जो बल्लाल देव लेके जाते हैं बाहुबली में, जो ब्लेड जैसा होता है सबको मार देता है, मास किलिंग। ये दोनों इनफैक्ट बाहुबली में राजमौली ने उधर से देख के लिया होगा। होप यू आर गेटिंग ये जो कैटापल्ट एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दी थिंग्स ही वन दी वॉर्स एंड ही एक्सटेंडेड हिज एम्पायर। Hope you are getting, but it is all not required for you for exam point of view. Just understand, Ajatasatru is very aggressive policy of expansion he followed, and he fought two wars against Kosala and Kashi, and second is against Lichavis. But that time Avanti was very powerful. Avanti defeated Vatsas and threatened Magadha. So Ajatasatru inke upar to jeet gaya hai bahut mehnat karke by manipulating the minister and all that. But अवंती से डरा है, सो ही फेस्ड स्ट्रॉन्ग राइवलरी फ्रॉम अवंती। दैट्स व्हाई अजातशत्रु फोर्टिफाइड राजगृह टू प्रोटेक्ट इट फ्रॉम एन इन्वेजन लेड बाय प्रज्योत। नो चंडा प्रज्योत महासेना हु वाज वेरी पॉपुलर एंड पावरफुल, ही इज आल्सो वेरी पावरफुल एंड एग्रेसिव। सो इसके वजह से ही फोर्टिफाइड द राजगृह सिटी। इवन इफ यू गो देयर नाउ आल्सो यू कैन फाइंड द you know, those remains of that fortification. Anyway, Prajyota has never invaded, but you know, with that dar ke wajah se, he has fortified it. After that, Ajatasatru was succeeded by Udayan. Udayan is important because he has shifted the capital from Rajagriha to Pataliputra. Udayan built a fort on confluence of Ganga and Son at Pataliputra and made it capital. पहले राजगृह, व्हेन मगधा वाज स्मॉल राजगृह वाज ओके, नाउ आफ्टर एक्सटेंडिंग द एम्पायर पाटलिपुत्र ऑलमोस्ट बिकेम द सेंटर ऑफ द एम्पायर, एट द मिडिल ऑफ द किंगडम, यू नो इट इज देयर। सो दैट्स व्हाई ही शिफ्टेड देयर, बिकॉज इवन यू नो देयर सोन इज द कॉन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ सोन एंड गैंजेस एंड ऑल, सो ही शिफ्टेड द कैपिटल टू पाटलिपुत्र। सो दिस इज अबाउट हरियंका डायनेस्टी। After this, Udayan succeeded by Shishunaga dynasty. So, Hariyanka dynasty is over. Now, Shishunaga dynasty has taken over. Shishunaga shifted their capital to Vaishali. Now, Kosala, Vajis and all these, Magadha ka part ban gaya hai. They shifted their capital to Vaishali. And you know, the greatest achievement of Shishunagas was they defeated Avanti. See, Avanti was very strong. But after Prajyota, Shishunagas became stronger here. And you know, Prajyota ke death ke baad, that Avanti has little, you know, downside. So they defeated Avanti. After this, Shishunaga dynasty is succeeded by Nandas. See, very basic questions exam mein puchega, agar aayega to bhi. Bahut broad natured questions aata hai. Maybe, you know, he can give you Haryanka dynasty, Shishunaga dynasty, then Nanda dynasty and Maurya dynasty. Arrange them in chronological order. Aisa puch sakta hai. Bahut hi simple. Broad nature mein samajh lijiye. Just for an idea, I am going deep. Unless it is your optional, you need not go so deep. Just upar upar se samajh lijiye. Shishunagas were succeeded by Nandas. Nandas were most powerful rulers of Magadha. Because by that time, most of that area is under Magadha. I mean under Nanda Empire. Even Alexander was conscious of their strength. At the time Alexander invaded India, Nandas were ruling that side. So that was one of the reason why, you know, Alexander followers, they stopped at the Vyas River. So that all we will learn in pre-Mauryan invasions. Nanda added Kalinga to Magadha. So Kalinga also they added to Magadha. Finally, Chandragupta Maurya overthrew the last Nanda ruler, Dhanananda, and established the Maurya dynasty. So about Maurya dynasty, we talk in Mauryan's topic. Hope you understand. This is all the rise of Magadha. Broadly samajh lijiye. Brihadratha dynasty, Haryanka dynasty se it became prominent. Then after that, Haryanka dynasty mein again Bimbisara, Ajatasatru, Udayan. After that, it came with Shishunaga dynasty, then Nanda dynasty and Maurya dynasty. Hope you got it. Now let us see some previous questions to get an idea how the questions are being asked. Take a question asked in 2014. Which of the following kingdoms were associated with the life of the Buddha? Avanti, Gandhara, Kosala, Magadha. See how silly question it is. Gautam Buddha, he visited all Gangetic plain mein jo bhi kingdoms hai, ve sare. Kaun si Gandhara gaya hai? Getting me? Even you see how broad the options are. So you can easily eliminate second. Getting me? Second can be eliminated, so A and B are eliminated. Now you see Avanti, clearly it is told, like Pradyota requested him to go because of his old age he could not go, and hence he appointed his deputy or his disciple Mahakatyayana. Even the wife of Pradyota was a disciple of him. Getting me? So one is wrong. So Kosala, you know, even last 24 years he stayed there. Even Prasenjit, king of Kosala, was a disciple of Buddha. Magadha, you know, Rajgir and all, first he went there only. I mean, you know, well associated, even before getting enlightenment. So he went to Rajgir, and there he used to take alms and he used to live the life of an ascetic. So third and four only. See the answer. The same question was again asked in 2015. Just copy paste, only maybe options are jumbled. So Avanti, Gandhara, Kosala, Magadha. So 3 and 4 only. Take this question asked in 2005. Who among the following was not a contemporary of the other three? You know Bimbisara? Bimbisara even offered his throne to Gautam Buddha when he was in Rajgir. And Prasenjit, he spent lot of time there. Even if you see the last question and this question, both are same. Prasenjit, Kosala, Bimbisara, Magadha. So Gautam Buddha associated with them and very closely associated with these persons also. Getting me? So A, B, D, they are all contemporaries. Whereas Milinda, we learn about him in post-Mauryan invasions. Kaun si Mauryan Empire? Bahut baad ki baat hai. Uske baad jo aata hai Milinda Panho, ye saare hum dekhenge Indo-Greeks mein. So C is not contemporary. Milinda is not contemporary. That is the answer. Very basic questions come in the exam if you understand the concepts properly. Take a question asked in 2000. Which one of the following dynasties was ruling over North India at the time of Alexander's invasion? Alexander kab aaya tha? Just before Mauryas. At the time, Nandas were ruling from Magadha. That was the region, even you know, they were very powerful, Nandas. Even they know that. I mean, Alexander followers. So, Nanda is the answer. After that, even you better understand about this when we talk about Mauryas. In fact, Chandragupta Maurya also had seen the working of Alexander. Hence, you know, he went and defeated the last ruler of Nanda, Dhanananda, and he took the throne. So, Nanda is the answer. Again, very broad-natured question. A question from 1999. Which one of the following was initially the most powerful city-state of India in the 6th century BC? See, obviously by looking at it, you can say Gandhar, Kamboj. So they are like, some texts even mentioned that they are only Janapadas. Some texts mentioned they are Mahajanapadas. But they are not very powerful. Like if there is Avanti, Magadha, Kashi, aisa options diya hoga to confusing hai. So A and B you can easily eliminate. There is a confusion, like most of you think Magadha was very powerful. Yes, Magadha was powerful. It became powerful slowly. But you look at the question, like if it is the case, why he asked initially? Magadha was not just powerful. After that, it emerged the most powerful kingdom out of all. Then why he had to mention which was the powerful kingdom initially? That means initially it was powerful, later it was not powerful. That is the meaning of the question. See, even most of the resources have given D as the answer. But I say C the answer. Because Kashi was most powerful initially. At the time, even Bimbisara time pay, he could not defeat them. So he went for matrimonial alliances and all. Then Ajatashatru, even he had to work hard to defeat the Kashi and Kosala. Usko defeat karne ka almost 16 years laga. Then he manipulated with the minister of Prasenjit and slowly he got it. And that too you see, look at the question, city-state. Kashi was a very small state with the surrounding Varanasi. So initially the most powerful city-state, Kashi.
though it looks like Magadha. Hope you are getting the way of asking the question. It's a tricky question. So see the answer here. Hope you are getting. So this is all the topic of Mahajanapadas. Very small and simple topic, not very important. Occasionally you get a question. Hope you understand. Thank you for watching.